In this video, learn how to switch from animation idle to walk. Using only one line of code, Animator play. And how to play animation idle when player stopped movement. How to create animation from one image. How to use event wait for seconds. When do you need to use event enumerator? And start coroutine event. How to stop playing the same animation repeatedly. Let's get started. In video part 3, we created animations for player, but it always is player walk animation. Now let's set default animation as player idle. When player is moving, let's switch to animation player walk. Currently, only default animation player idle is playing. On player object, we created component animator, which controls all animations of our player. Let's open our script player controller. First of all, get component animator with a new public variable. Name it player animator, or any names you want. Now on Unity Editor, you can add component animator to this variable. Just hold and drop object player into. It will automatically pick component animator and add it in. Whenever you press button D or A, event player move will be called to move our player. To play an animation, use event play from component animator. Hover on it to see how to use it. It needs a state name, is name of animation you want to play. Make sure you enter correct name in animator controller. Play animation player walk. Control S to save the script. When player moves, animation player walk will be played. Our script has worked. Now when no buttons are pressed, let's switch back to animation player idle. If button D is not pressed, event else will trigger. After that, if button is not pressed also, another event else will trigger. It means, inside this else event, no move buttons are pressed. So player will stop movement, and play animation player idle. Let's create new void event animation stop. When player is not moving, we play animation player idle. Make sure you enter correct name. Save our script. Press play. Player moves. Play animation player walk. Player stops movement. Player idle is played. If you watch carefully, player idle is played while jumping as well. Actually, player can walk and stop movement when he is on ground only. To fix it, before we play animation player walk and player idle, let's check if player is standing on ground or not. Animation player walk can be played only if player is on ground. Do the same for animation player idle. Press play. Now it cannot switch animation idle or walk while jumping anymore. Let's open character images. I don't have his animation jump here. So let's pick it from one of these images. To create animation from one image, select that image, then choose animation. Name this player jump. Now add it into player animator controller. Open our script, at button jump. Let's add new event to play animation player jump after button is pressed. Name this event is animation jump. Let's create new void event with this name. After player is jumped, just play animation player jump. If you pressed play now, animation player jump not working. Actually, animation player jump was played in one frame only. The reason is, it needs a little time for variable on ground to change. So if you play animation player jump while it is still on ground, another animation will overlap it right away. To fix the issue, after button jump is pressed, let's give it little bit time before play animation player jump. Use event wait for seconds to wait. 0.1 second is enough. There is some error, let's check it out how to use this event. Just type event name on Google. There is always some example on Unity website. To use wait for seconds event, you need to use yield return new before it. Copy and paste it into. This error said that you need to convert it to a float number. To do that, just add letter F after the number. It still has one more error with our event name here. To use yield return new, our function need to be enumerator. Let's fix it. So you cannot use void here. Change it to enumerator. No more errors now. One more thing, to call a enumerator event, you must use start coroutine. Scroll up at button jump. Use start coroutine to call event animation jump. Everything should work well now. Yield return means, it will wait for some time. And after it waits enough time, it will continue to read the next line of code. Run the game and try to jump now. Animation player jump worked very well. All animations works perfect. Event on update will run every frames. So it will call event animation stop, every frames too. At this event, after animation player idle is played, let's print a message. Press play to test it. As you see, animation player idle is called repeatedly, so many times. It might affect your game and make it run slower. Open player controller script. Create a new variable with type is string. Name it current animation. With initial name is player idle. Or without any names is good too. Now scroll down and create new event to handle this issue. New event with name playing animation. Add one input value for it. It will be animation name that you want to play. From now, if you want to play any animation, we will use this new event to replace the old ones. Its input will be animation you want to play. to stop to play the same animation again. We will compare the current animation with next animation name. If they are different, we will play the new animation. First, set the current animation is the animation you want to play. Then play the new animation. Let's print out a message to see what animation is playing currently. Now, if you want to play any animations, just call this new event. Then add animation name into. Delete the old one. Do the same for player idle. And player walk. Press play to see the final result. Animation player idle is played one time only now. When you move, animation player walk is called one time as well. Also with player jump, everything works perfect. You understand how to create animations and switch any animations from now. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to save the video. Thank you for watching, and see you in next tutorial.